Okay, this is where we left off. We need to think of a strategy. We have one army here, one here, and one up there. So that's four armies we can play with. This one will advance here. This one over there will advance there. They will probably try to attack this, which is where this army will go. Then this army over here can move on towards St. Petersburg and then Karelia, and maybe from there on to the White Sea. This army from here can go to Moscow, and maybe they can then go on to there and then up there. One army, the one that goes here, can go down there and then over here and go up here. We should try not to enter the wilderness because I think there's attrition there. And while we are doing this, Sweden will probably declare on us because they have to conquer St. Petersburg. But they only have two provinces, so they're quick to fall. Okay, they are there. They have a lot of coverage. I don't think they can do much, if anything, either way. But if we get a peace treaty with them, it won't hurt either. Actually, I might pull them back. Or should I? Nah, I have to advance. I have to... Oh, Sweden. I have to conquer them fast so they cannot build up. Okay, that's an interesting development. They are here. I could pull this army up here. Then we can conquer that. There is a French army here. Oh, okay. They are at war with Württemberg, Bavaria. So they are at war with these and they are losing. Then let's conquer this. They are already allied with Russia, so I can also conquer them afterwards. Only one artillery. They will. Do they? Can still reach here, so that's fine. Can they see? Yeah, they can see the gate from here. I think they're shooting at their own buildings. This is why I want to forge disable, because it's just... it doesn't work. this is why I want to be able to disable forts. I think the option even works, but it's just a couple of forts that are already spawned in at the start of a campaign that remain. It just turns into a slugfest. Now I can melee myself into this fort, but if I do that, they have all the advantage. Should I melee into it or not? If I collapse this section of the wall, they will have to split up their troops between those two spots. Or they're just stupid. Hello. Hello, Dab. I don't actually remember how you do it correctly. I think it should come with an installer. And with this installer, you should just select your main directory. In order to uninstall Darthmod, you have to... Well, you have to boot the launcher. Then click on the X as if you were to close it down and select as setting it to start in vanilla. And if you do that, the launcher restores the vanilla files. Then you can uninstall Darthmod. And if you want to be really certain, uninstall Empire and delete all of the files in the directory. And either you reinstall Empire if you've done that, or if you have not deleted it, just reinstall Darthmod. Because everything that Darthmod does is it's just an interface that it replaces vanilla files with the files of the mod. Say for example the start pause file, which edits the campaign, essentially. Now, should I just melee into this? Oh, you're welcome. I am going to take casualties, but I think I'll just melee into it. It takes so fucking long. Oh, you bet your ass they have grape shot loaded. But they'll have to kill their own guys. Actually, this is a good idea. Does this work? Can I pull them out? Yes, I can. The AI is stupid. Just a galaxy brain AI. But they don't follow. Okay, they don't seem to quite follow, so we'll have to melee through. Or do we? They are shooting themselves in the back. Their weakest points are on the right flank on the center. They have concentrated their troops there. Yeah, now they shot. Actually, they don't even use grape shot. What losers. Okay, they only killed 400. I was feeling like it was more, but anyhow. I'm letting them heal some. Also, another thing I want to do is replace these demi cannons with 12-inch. At least for now, later on howitzers. Because the 12-inch reloads about twice as fast, I think, as the demi cannon, and has otherwise the same statistics. Whereas the howitzers can also use those fire shots or lime shots or something. This should work out well, unless they come over here on this hill because of the inclination. Does this work? No, no. Okay, this should almost. What if they come down there? I don't know, the AI is probably not thinking about something like inclination of my cannons. Fuck, they can't do. None of these can do the circle formation, which is good against cavalry. If you don't have tactics, you just use a big gun. Maybe that is the best strategy, the best tactic. Why are none of these shooting? Yeah, this battle had some unnecessary casualties.
Thank you. the Wehrmacht! Sieg!
Marsch! Vorwärts für Krone und Vaterland! Truppen, vorwärts! Für Befehle.
So now we're phasing out militias.
Majestät, wir wünschen Hahn, ein Ort des Lernens und der Kultur.
Sir, eure Befehle? Befehle. Vorwärts! Marsch!
Eure Befehle, Majestät?
Euer Majestät? Wie kann ich euch dienen?
Der Diener Gottes.
Euer Majestät?
Mein Motto ist Diskretion. Verstecke mich. Tauche unter.
Yeah, we'll just take Aronia next round or the round afterwards. It is interesting to see Crimea conquer stuff. This faction, Crimea, is just the underdog in this game. One of the poorest provinces, starts out as a vassal. Hey Acer. So it is interesting that they are conquering stuff in Russia now. Like, if you have a faction unlocker, starting as the Crimea Incarnate is the hardest campaign you can get in this game. I'm not sure what to do about Sweden because they are expanding here now. And Crimea is also. I mean, we could just wait until Russia reconquers these provinces, if they do at all. Because it looks like Russia has declared war on us, on the Ottomans, and Sweden has on them, so they are encircled. Let's see, we have four armies, all of them are up there, which means if France were to declare on us, we have nothing to defend ourselves down here. Also, interestingly, Spain is invading down here. We could invade the papacy. Okay, so can we wait? Great Britain. Okay. There is no cancel. Okay. I should have declared war on Coronia last round. After Russia, I probably should expand westwards. It's almost inevitable that either France or Spain will declare on us. One issue will be Sardinia, because as long as Spain has provinces in Europe, their faction will not disband. We have no military ports. Okay, in 5 rounds we can get. Oh, Rijeka, Flaum in German. And this city is not down here, but up here, IRL. This city is positioned wrong. And there we have Zadar. That would be down here somewhere. Who knows, maybe Britain will get rid of the alliance with Coronia at some point. What should we do? We could invade St. Petersburg. That would give us a strong city in the north. Also, yes, if you have noticed this already, the background music in this game changes depending on which part of the world you're hovering over. Right now I'm hovering over like Eastern Europe, the Austrian Empire, so you get a Catholic church sound in the background. If you go down here, sort of like a Mediterranean, Levantine. Though I think the Catholic church chants will just be all over Europe, and no. No, now it's giving the Mediterranean music, so probably over Iberia and stuff. We have no military ports. They are really allying the world. So war with them is almost inevitable. That's an interesting development. Yeah, France is now bordering us. Oh, they have howitzers. I wonder what the papacy is up to. They are not at war with anybody in this area. But they did send an invasion fleet. We really have to build a military port here.
Was wünscht ihr?
This is fortunate. They have no army here.
Thank you.
Okay, a shipyard, so this could be used as a military port. But it's so far away from the Mediterranean. This is actually not the Baltic Sea, this is Lake Ladoga.
Was wünscht ihr? Beobachte eure Feinde. Eine unmögliche Aufgabe, Sir. Noch eine Mission im Dienste eurer Majestät. Zu euren Diensten.
Okay, now we allied Britain, because they are allied with everybody. This might get us into a war with France. I think Spain keeps trying to steal our research, and that's why they move back and forth.
erwartet sie. Oh, hallo.
Bereit machen! Warten auf weitere Befehle!
Wie kann ich euch dienen?
I really should try conquering the papacy. Nice. Oh, that's the militia. Yeah. In case of a cavalry attack, they will be useless. I will disable AI moves. If the AI keeps on spawning one regiment armies. Okay, they are advancing down here actually.
Thank you.
Now that they have retaken this, I could re-implement my strategy which I had in mind. Which is taking this army over here. Then this army could go for the middle and they could go over there. Wait, they are blocked here, so they might just go to Moscow. Carcass shot. That's the fire. These combined with firing by rank is an overpowered combination.
Mit eurer Erlaubnis. Aha, ein Ort des Lernens und der Kultur.
Archery. guerrillas and one streltsy. It is interesting that the pirates are surviving this long. I can't attack them while they're in there.
Thank you.
Well, I hope this works out.
Thank you.
Enemies killed 500, 2500. They might be able to retake St. Petersburg while this army is going towards Moscow. This army down here could sneak around us.
Oop.
Hey.
Hey, how's it going? And also, hello there, Argus chat.
It's kind of funny, I've now streamed this game twice, and twice, once each stream, I've been asked about how to install this mod for this game.
Neat.
Okay, so now I have two problems. This army down here, and this army over here.
Neat.
Could be that Russia takes Crimea, or that Crimea takes Muscovy before my army arrives. Okay, firing by rank. That's okay. They have no allies. Wait, what? Why is the papacy a vassal of Dagestan? Oh well.
Majestät. Wir werden siegen!
Oh.
Thank you.
France is almost dissolved. They only need to conquer Savoy, Alsace. Yeah, Württemberg is probably going to take Alsace. And whoever takes this down here will just kick out one of the major players. They are being besieged.
Linke Seite, Marsch. Erwarten Befehle. Männer,
yeah, it's Crimea.
Linke Seite, Marsch. Verlust. Marsch. Armee. If we hadn't chosen World Conquest, we would now have won the campaign. Thank you.
Yeah, so long as Crimea controls Moscow, I will not advance. Yeah, Meissener porcelain. You know, that was a big thing. They are just going to retreat themselves over to our capital, aren't they? We could conquer them. Yeah, I wonder what happens around Muscovy. I would have appreciated them conquering something a bit closer to them. Actually, we are at 3 hours. I could leave it there for the day. Yeah, I think I will. Hope you've enjoyed it, and we'll probably continue tomorrow. Let's see, we have one here, two, three armies, and a fourth one down here. Yeah. Okay, I'll leave it there for the day.